the relevance is that there is DNA there. Not sufficient enough for her to make a determination as to who it belongs to or what it is, but there is something there. And that is it, nothing more. Now, there's a huge difference between being able to report something, exclusion or inclusion. We're not discussing that. We're discussing whether DNA material, and the witness has already testified, that if it passes the 50 threshold, that is an indication that there's something there. That's it. As far as, now, if that is fair game for cross-examination, when Mr. Ashton wants to get up and say, you can't say this, you can't say that, you can't do this, and that's fine. But as far as what I'm trying to elicit from the witness, is simply that there was a portion of DNA there, and that's it, nothing more.
The problem is, to what end? Is counsel going to elicit this and then at some later point argue to the jury that somehow that bit of DNA could have been amplified, could have been this, could have been that, without scientific support? Unless it is relevant to an issue, then it's meaningless. It's not relevant.
If it's not relevant, why is the shovel in evidence?
Judge, no. The shovel is in evidence.
Mr. Ashton, calm down.
Sir.
Okay? Calm down. Sit down for a second.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Have you finished, Mr. Baez?
Well, my point is, Judge, this shovel has been brought into evidence. It is a relevant piece of evidence. There's testimony been admitted that Miss Anthony borrowed the shovel.
I'm not concerned. I'm concerned about her testimony and what she's going to say. Okay. You have anything else to say about her testimony?
Nothing further, sir.
Okay. Mr. Ashton. Reply from the state of Florida.
Yes, sir. I still would submit that the fact that there is a scientifically meaningless result on a test isn't relevant unless it can be tied into some issue in the case. And my concern is that counsel is going to, without eliciting from a witness whether this could ever be used to do anything, argue to the jury something that we know is scientifically incorrect. I think it needs to be relevant for some argument or some issue before the court.
The converse to that, Mr. Ashton, is those are things that you can ask her in your cross-examination. Ma'am, the results that Mr. Baez is seeking to elicit from you, exactly what does those results mean?
All I can tell you, Your Honor, is that there is a peak there, and it is...
Is it DNA?
Considering that the initial threshold of determining a peak is at 50, and that peak does appear above 50 RFUs, it is a peak and is consistent with an X of at the amylogenin typing, or at the locus. So I have no other information other than there is a peak.
There's a peak, and it is an X, you say?
Yes, sir.
Okay, and what does that translate into?
Well, it's potentially could be from a female. It could be from a male. It's at such a low level in my report for the conclusion that I gave is that it is do not satisfy the reporting criteria, and no conclusion can be offered.
So you can't say whether it originated from a male or a female?
Well, with the absence of a Y peak, all I can tell you is there's an X there.
And you can draw absolutely no conclusions from that?
No, sir.
Okay.
I'm not asking for any conclusions of the witness, nor will I ascertain. The only thing that I was attempting
Okay, let me cut both of you short. I will permit you to ask the question. The state can clear it up in cross-examination, and then the jury can take it for whatever it's worth.